Last week, Adobe announced its integration of its generative AI Firefly into Photoshop. Firefly, the gift that keeps on giving and the newest, biggest contender in the image generative AI space, was announced as Bard's image generator about 2 weeks ago. And now, Generative Fill, a new feature, has been added to Photoshop, which is also powered by Firefly. For those who are unfamiliar, Firefly is a video and photo editing generative AI software from Adobe, with a super easy to use interface and some of the most fully fledged features available on any image or video generative AI software. I talk about all its video editing capability in my video about how anyone can now do video editing. In a major surprise, Adobe announced the Generative Fill feature, which can remove complex objects from images, extend and change photo backgrounds, and generate realistic objects in existing photos. Generative Fill, which is now available through Photoshop Beta on Creative Cloud, is not the same as Photoshop's content-aware fill tool. Seeing as Adobe Firefly is itself still in beta, and goodness, I have been waiting for access for weeks now, I didn't expect this integration with Photoshop now, and certainly not so soon. I could honestly say the same thing for the Bard Firefly integration, but it seems that Adobe is sprinting past the competition and saying, photo and video editing tools is our domain, and not even your generative AI apps could change that. Generative Fill works by using Firefly AI Image Generator to manipulate existing images on Photoshop, saving designers and photo editors hours of productive time. AI is not new to Photoshop, as one of their more popular features, very similar to Generative Fill, has always used some sort of AI, like its content-aware fill and magic eraser tool. The difference with Generative Fill is that it uses generative AI to not only remove backgrounds, but replace them with images and elements essentially out of thin air. For the feature to work, you do need to be connected to the internet and you need to have installed Photoshop Beta. There's a link in the description of this video to show you how and where to do that. Similar to other AI image generators, Generative Fill mostly relies on prompts to create images and edit your photos. For example, to remove the skid marks from this image of a biker, you simply draw the cutout with the skid marks and click Generative Fill. Or you want to add yellow lines to this road, simply type the text prompt and it will generate it. Prompts, however, are not always necessary, as Generative Fill does have the ability to understand the background or context of the selected cutout and automatically fills it with the nearly exact details. The image generated by Generative Fill is usually done on a new layer, which allows designers and editors to edit their work non-destructively. And when using a non-existent object with a prompt, the new object is added onto a layer mask and the layer is named the prompt that you used for generating said object. The content-aware fill tool, however similar to Generative Fill, is far less superior and relies heavily on the properties of the image to act as a duplicator of sorts and has far less actual awareness of the image context compared to Generative Fill, which creates fairly realistic images like with this example on the screen. Generative Fill will not work if your image doesn't have a large enough portion highlighted, as the AI wouldn't have enough context to work with, and Generative Fill doesn't do a great job at generating humans and some animals realistically, which is a shortcoming of the Firefly AI training data, which is sourced from LEGO, but a far less robust data set in comparison to competitions like Midjourney and DALL-E. Generative Fill excels at generating reflective backgrounds with water, so much so that YouTuber and Photoshop authority figure PTC says you may never need another water plugin again. Examples like creating a reflection of a pyramid-like structure on land like this, or generating water around the feet and background of a person standing in the street. For all its strength, a Generative Fill tool weakness is in its inability to generate transparent backgrounds around the object that it creates. This means that each generated object, for example this car, cannot be moved around the photo to change its position as the background is not transparent. So you will have to regenerate the image to match the background of the new position of the image, which is just a lot of work. Unlike Midjourney, objects and images generated with Generative Fill conform to the quality and style of the existing image, and one does not need to specify things like image quality as 4K, HD, or image style like photography, watercolor that the image may be in. Lastly, a very huge issue which is a disadvantage to Photoshop beginners is the importance of selection when editing and prompting Generative Fill. Over-selection or using the wrong selection tool can ruin images and, in unique cases, completely change the character you intend to edit. Honestly, this feature is just great, but not nearly perfect yet, and there is so much I couldn't cover on this video in order for it to be brief. However, I've linked a great video by Photoshop Training Channel with a more comprehensive look at the features, the advantages and disadvantages. Let me know your thoughts on this new feature and if you've tried it. Check out Adobe Firefly, the engine behind Generative Fill that lets anyone do video editing. Thank you so much for watching and have a great rest of your week.